Know anyone who could use a good ass chewing?
I could use a good ass kick, and I'll be very honest with you.
But what if you could get that message delivered by an authentic drill instructor who spent 33 years in the Army?
Ha ha ha!
You asked for it. For just $35, you can get a customized knife hand ass chewing for a person of your choice straight from the Popster.
I think you aren't even good enough to whiff the farts from a dog's ass!
And monthly supporters of the regiment receive a $10 discount.
I am hard, but I am fair!
Use the Cash App code on the screen to send your donation along with notes on the person whose ass needs chewing. And the Popster will handle the rest.
So, shut the fuck up!
What's going on, you Diaka-thinking debutantes? Say that three times and see how it works out for you. Terrence Pop from Edonkulous.com, and yes, the dyslexicist is in the house. Today we have a sweet 16 list of absolute lies that we all believe while we're young and dick thinking. And why did we fall for these lies? Because the women who raised us flat out lied to us from the beginning. They will put their hand on a stack of Bibles and swear, "All I want is a nice guy." But if you look closely at that stack of Bibles, it's actually a stack of diakas, and you should probably go wash your hands. And the reason they lie is because their genuine desires make them look like cheetah flipping whores.
Let's pretend that's not true.
Yeah.
And guess what, ladies? That is completely okay as long as you're honest with yourself and those you wish to copulate with. But lying to us and lying to yourselves, are you surprised you're not happy and on head meds? There's a reason why divorce and binge drinking rates have gone through the roof. And it sure isn't because you are strong and independent. I'm gay. Every time I have to do that snap, I die a little bit inside. I'm my own personal Thanos. Watch me disappear in a cloud of dust. Just like your fertility screen 5. Bottom line, gentlemen, if you want to figure out what women want, you pay attention to their actions, not their words. With that being said, it's time to talk about scabies and baby rabies. So pour yourself a menagerie or some herbal tea with a couple shots of Cut My Balls in it, and let's get this show started! Yeah, as a dude in the West, you are held to an impossible standard every single day of your life. A vast majority of ladies out there want a body type that only 14% of men actually have. Imagine, if you will, you are at Weight Watchers, you fat bastards, and they have one pie for dessert, but they have to split it amongst 10 women. 8 of those women are all gonna want the same piece of pie, and the hell with the rest of it. And here's the real bizarre part. They will gladly share that one sliver of pie amongst them all. It's disturbing to think about, but it's true. Meanwhile, 85% of that pie, which is perfectly fine, goes untouched. And because they're all sharing the same piece of pie, it's never fulfilling. But now get this. They will insist there's not enough good pie for everyone. Where the hell have all the good pies gone, huh? Space Ghost is on.
Where are my pies?
So right off the bat, you know you're dealing with picky, shallow people. So we are going to count off the 4 powers that be that are working against you every single day. These are the 4 things women are using to decide if you are marriageable or not. And if you are lacking in any one of these 4, it will be an excuse for them to monkey branch to the next diaka. Number 1, shocker of all shockers, want to smell it? Money. Modern women actually believe you are worthless if you are not stacking $500,000 a year.
How much should a guy earn for you to date him? Over 500K, close to $1 million. If he doesn't, I'm not gonna say yes, do you hear me?
Do you have any idea how difficult it is to find a dude under 40 who makes that kind of money? It's virtually impossible. Here's the stat. And you wonder why us men call you delusional. Give me a break. And that's just the first one on the list. The next one is power. If you are famous or have a bunch of alphabet soup after your name, you wield a lot of power. What's alphabet soup? CEO, CFO, ESQ, DDS, kind of sounds like a sexual position, but it's not. MD, PhD, which does not stand for pretty huge diaka. And if you don't have that, let's be honest here, they're still gonna leave you. There are post-wall thoughts leaving celebrities for whatever reason every single day. And why? Because they think they can do better. Don't you dare snap. Spoiler alert, ladies, the grass is greener where you water it. And it's not piss either. But I can already hear the dudes out there. I'm just a young guy. I don't have any power. That is untrue. The average dude walking around out there stealing oxygen has way more power than they realize. When they're young, you're gullible and you're more than likely willing to trade that power for a piece of poon, oh baby. And that makes you it just makes you normal.
Men should grow up.
Yeah, and dogs should stop licking themselves. It's not gonna happen.
But if you trade your power for respect, guess what? The world is yours and poon comes along with it. Now listen, most dudes out there will figure this out by the time they get to about 35 when they stop thinking with the little Richard. And that realization only takes effect after a boatload of pain and rage. And that's why I'm here. I'm trying to tell the younger dudes how to plan for it and think ahead. Don't make the same mistakes I did. Believe me, you don't want to do that. Number three is status, which most people equate to money and power. But look at cops and military. The uniform comes with a lot of status and power. As a private in the army, I didn't get paid shit, but I slayed a fair amount of poon now.
Sweet.
Hey, stop! You're gonna hurt her feelings, bro. But the novelty of that uniform, it will wear off. And when it does, they're gonna want the money and the next pogo stick to ride on. Number four, which is actually the first thing women notice, and that is looks. Looks are the difference between a keeper and a creeper. I don't care if you're as good looking as Brad Pitt via 1991. If you don't have a 6-inch penis or a 6-figure income or are 6 feet tall, your options are severely limited in current year. You are going to have to play the dirty, long game if you want to be in a family kind of way, if you know what I mean. Now, are these rules that apply to every set of mama milkers out there? Of course not. There are genuinely good women out there. Trust me, there are. But they're exceedingly rare and the juice is no longer worth the squeeze. Especially when it can come with a false essay accusation and you might go to prison. I did a whole show on it, links below. It doesn't matter how old you are or which head you're thinking with. You are aware of these powers that be on some level. And because of these powers, it feeds into the delusion that poon is something scarce. And when you're thinking with a little head, you're more likely to believe these lies. Because you are stupid enough thinking if you believe these, it'll get you laid. It might get your diaka wet in the short term, but the fucking you get is not gonna be worth the fucking that you get.
I know. That's why I call the hooker.
With that being said, it's time to jump into the Sweet 16, which is becoming less sweet as we go along in time. There are 16-year-old girls out there who already have the 1,000 kiaka stare. Yeah! Number one.
It's okay. I'm religious.
That one is the death knell call of a woman about to hit the wall and screaming for a provider. And when you find out about their past, they all have the same catchphrase.
Only God can judge me.
You are absolutely right. Hang on a second, I got a call. Oh, it's God. Yeah, what's going on? Yeah, that's what I thought. Yeah, you're correct. You're a whore, Screen 5.
You see what he did there?
Now that I've secured my position for my walkthrough in hell, number two.
I love you.
This is just like the marriage vows, and it is not the complete sentence. I love you for now, or I love you if the money keeps rolling in. How many dudes out there got broken up with or divorced after they were laid off or injured at work? Oh, that's right, most of you. Men, they fall in love. Women, they fall in line and they can step out just as fast. If you start looking at relationships with a business mindset, you will understand this more and more.
I'll get down on all fours for a Michael Kors.
Who's that? And please tell me I don't have to watch.
Oh no, silly, it's just a purse.
A purse? That's worse. Space Ghost is on. Number three.
I'm a good person.
Well, if you have to say that, chances are you're not.
How dare you?
Just like you are not strong and independent just because you pay your own bills. It's called being an average adult. Welcome to the human race. Too bad you're gonna lose. The only place where you'll beat me in a foot race is that run to Box Wine and Catman, Screen 5.
Stop! Don't touch me there! This is my no-no square! Stop!
Number four, and this ties into so many classic mistakes that men make.
Don't worry, it'll be fine.
You get this line right after she swears she's on the pill and takes it at the same time every day. 6 to 8 weeks later, you find out you have a warrant for baby jail, and that's gonna last you 18 to 21 years, depending upon the state you're in. I can't even make fun of you for this, dudes, because I absolutely fell for this shit myself. When a woman looks back and goes,
go ahead, put it in the warehouse.
Every dude out there is like, okay. You're an idiot, stop it, man! You go from zero to old baby in about 5 seconds. But don't worry, dudes. Number five.
I'm not like other girls.
And this one comes in many forms, and my personal favorite is...
I don't normally do this.
As you slip it into the cavernous butthole on the first date, Screen 5. If you've never heard her fart, you need to ask yourself why. I feel so dirty. I literally feel like I have to take a shower now. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Listen, if she's ripping ass and it sounds like a bunch of choir boys yawning, you have a much bigger problem. The ironic thing about this statement is it admits something without actually stating it. This woman is admitting that most women are a bunch of money-grubbing sluice-de-toots.
It's not true.
It is true.
And number five is right up there with number three. If you have to say it, well, it's probably not true. And you have to ask yourself this. Who is she trying to convince? You or herself? Number six is what happens if you believe 1 through 5. Well, it didn't work out and I'm getting divorced, but I'm going to get a fair shake in court. Of course you are. Out of the thousands of veterans and service members I've talked to over the years about their divorce experience, about 2% actually got a fair shake in court. Even I was referred to as a murderer and an assassin in open court in front of the judge. And all I fucking did was the job the government wanted me to do and trained me to do. I'm still fucking pissed. If the people who actually fought for this country can't get a fair shake in court, what hope do you have?
Please take that out of my ass.
And with that image fresh in your brain, number seven.
Prenups totally work.
Prenups is kind of like a condom. If you get crazy with it, it'll break and you can still get the burning ring of fire. Burning ring of fire. No, thank you. Even if you're aware of all of these lies, at best, it's a risk reduction, and that is it. There are no guarantees, but it'll be fine, Space Ghost is on. Number 8, please gentlemen, don't fall for this.
Real men get married.
This one here is emasculation 101. Don't fall for that bullshit. The last person on this earth who knows what a real man is a woman. According to modern 304s, I'm not a real man because I refuse to fall in line. And get this, I hold women accountable for their decisions and actions. Oh my God! Ah! If you have to resort to demeaning your man, you don't respect him, and it's a matter of time before he knows it. Dudes, if you hear this coming out of a woman's mouth aimed at you, it's over. Fucking eject. And ladies, if you find yourself using these words, you need to remember this term.
Okay, no uterus, no opinion.
According to your own logic, as a man, I'm not allowed to have an opinion on women. So, shut the fuck up! Well, besides that, in current year, men make better women anyway, Screen 5. Number 9, and this one is my favorite.
My past doesn't matter.
Alright, let's go to example world here. Let's just say you inherit $1 million! And because you're obviously not stupid, you want to invest the money and let it grow. Would you take that money to the investment banker with a history of bankruptcies or the dude with a stellar record? The choice is yours. If that dude's past doesn't matter, go ahead and give him the money and see what happens. I'll wait. Ladies, you have no idea how stupid you sound to men when you say these things. Because women are experts at drudging up the past to win arguments in the present. Personally, I blame the Spice Girls for number 9. They made it popular with this piece of shit. If you want my future, forget my past. But the next lyric is, if you want to get with me, you better make it fast. If you want to get with me, better make it fast. That is the battle cry of 5 glory hole attendants in training, Screen 5. Past behavior is an indicator of future behavior. And anyone who says different is straight up lying to you or trying to sell you swampland on the moon. And number 10 is the first lie all men are told when they are young. And guess what? That one lie is responsible for us believing the rest of the other 15.
Women just want a good man to take care of them.
I was raised by a single mother, and I was told this lie, which resulted in me getting divorced, homeless, and living out of my car. Of course I'm laughing at it now, and I laughed at it back then, because if I didn't, I would go nuts. Laughter really is the best medicine for psychological and spiritual injuries. And to all the single mothers out there who have said this lie, that is exactly what you are inflicting on your sons. This is dereliction of your parental duties. Think about that, ladies. Your job as a parent is to do your best to prepare your child for the ordeal of the real world. And you cannot do that properly with lies. Because of this reason, women cannot raise men. Sure, your child will become an adult, but in reality, the only thing he's fit for is to be a crash test dummy in current year relationship land. And that's why I'm here. I don't want these dudes to get wrecked and then have to put themselves back together to only get wrecked again. Because when it happens enough times, they become a number that I cannot put on this board. And I'm sick and tired of burying you mother fornicators, so listen up and pay attention. Because number 11 is the funniest one on this list.
You know what they say, happy wife, happy life.
Happiness is not something you find out there. It is something you find in here. But if you are foolish enough to believe happiness comes from another person, you will never be happy. Wah. Gee, I wonder why 80% of divorces are filed by women. I think it has something to do with Space Ghost is on.
Stupid! You're so stupid!
Here's the sad part. I can't just blame these ladies. I have to blame their parents as well. This is a familiar saying that has been passed down through eons of time. When women say this, they are putting a knife hand in your face and saying, it is all on you. Who needs or wants that kind of pressure today? Not me. And how narcissistic are you to expect happiness for what?
Vagina, vagina, vagina.
In current year, when you ask a woman what she brings to the table, she will look you in the face and go, I am the table, and that's still gay. They honestly think that this is clever. Here's an epiphany. You are the table. Wow! Down on all fours, waiting for somebody to put something on you, or let's face it, in you. So when you look at me and say you are the table, that is not the flex that you think it is. Number 12 is a direct result of you being stupid enough to believe number 11. Well, she's happy, so she won't cheat on me. She's different. She left me. Get the hell out of here. Women cheat more than men now. Fact, not opinion. Links on redonkulous.com. Check them out. And while this is going on behind your back, they are all spreading bullshit rumors about you. And why do they do this? So they can bring the whole garden shed of tools to their aid. You go, girl. You get the bag. You get yours, and I'm still gay. I fucking hate doing that.
Yeah.
You're such an asshole. After all, if you can justify evil behavior, that makes it less evil. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to get strange, just break up or divorce. It's just that simple. There are women out there who actually think this insanity, that it's totally normal to marry the dude that they were cheating with on their husband, and somehow that's going to work out. What?
You went full retard, man.
Well, he helped me cheat, so I can't trust him, so I'm gonna cheat fucking first.
And it just keeps going and going, and it just speeds up. And I call that the 75331 and done downward spiral. The first relationship, that's 7 years. It's a good run. The next one, five. And then you have a couple threes. And then a one. And after that, it's less than one. And you're done. And that is when you start hearing this.
Where have all the good men gone, Wee?
Well, the ones you didn't already shit on have ran far away from you. Winning.
Man, that's just mean. That's mean, man.
Lucky number 13, and I put this one here on purpose. I can make her happy. No, you're not. Ladies, no one can make you happy, but you have been told to expect happiness out of a man. And you've been told to blame that man for everything, even if it's your fault. Dating modern women in current year is kind of like working for an absolute shitty boss. He expects you to do your job and his job, but he can still fire you even if you do it perfectly. And why? Well, he just wasn't happy with your work. Who's gonna work 10 times as hard for 1/5 of the return? Certainly not me. Ironically, dating and the job market have this in common. Productivity through the roof, return in the toilet, which is where the condom should be when you're done with the bitch. Screen 5. Number 14 is one of the toughest lessons I myself had to learn. You think because you're that child's father, you're irreplaceable. And guess what? You're somewhat correct when it comes to your child. But when it comes to the uterus that dropped your child, you are fully replaceable. We live in an evil system that profits from destroying families and relationships. And it happens 5 days a week, 50 out of 52 weeks a year for decades. As soon as they incentivize breaking up the nuclear family, they destroyed this country. And women, they're lining up for this because they think it'll make them stunning and brave single mothers. In reality, what it makes you is the pawn that is subservient to the patriarchy you're trying to fight.
What?
You're feeding it money and votes on a daily basis, and you're too stupid to realize it. But you will never take accountability for that, will you? Nope, it's just easier to blame all men as the dildos of consequences plug up your dishwasher. 15 in the home stretch, and I love this one.
I love a male feminist.
What you mean is, you love the beta provider that you don't have to give sex to. Unless you're trying to secure a meal ticket for the next 18 to 21 years, Screen 5. Because only a narcissist will look you in the face and start a sentence with these words. Well, a real man would... Why do I keep doing that? God. That is a person who wants to control you with blame and shame. All for their own self-serving goals. But here's catch 22 or 69, depending upon these ladies. These desires and goals will never be reached or quenched because there is no self-love driving it. There is no real ambition unless you count evil. And that's not a word I throw around lightly. When you're talking about love and using it as a weapon against people, that is just raw evil.
Emotional damage! Where's the therapy button?
And that brings us to sweet 16. And this one here is a result of successful manipulation. I made a whole video about it, links in the description.
If I just work harder at this relationship, maybe she'll love me more.
No, that's not how this works. And all these relationships start off the same. You're getting love bombed, you're banging every day, sometimes two or three times a day with a blowjob, winning. And in between all of this, she's cooking, she's cleaning, she's doing everything in her power to make herself unreplaceable. But what she's really doing, she's just setting that hook. Once she knows that she has your commitment, all of the love bombing and sex falls off a cliff. And this is a calculated attempt to get more out of you while she provides even less. Because happy wife, happy life, it's on you to make her happy. And if she's not doing what she used to do, you must be doing something wrong. Once you realize that all of these lies are designed to control your behavior, there's a word for that. It's called abuse. And make no mistake, in current year, women have a monopoly that's enforced by the laws of this country to dish that shit out wholesale. And even if you call them out for it, they will never admit it and they'll never be held responsible for it. So it's up to you to be responsible for yourself. Memorize these lies, because I guarantee you this, you will hear them, and maybe if you're stupid, you'll use some of them yourself. I don't recommend it. Now, I've been saying this for years. Men are experts at setting their own death traps. Absolutely true. But this is a death trap most men can't climb out of. And the saddest part, it is 100% avoidable. All you really gotta do is something that they won't. Take responsibility and find your own happiness. Don't go looking for that happiness in a slot C, because you can scrub that shit till the cows come home. It's not gonna make you happy. Happiness is not something that can leak down another person's leg. I'm just saying. And remember, the example that your parents or parent set for you is very important. No matter how screwed up it was, it felt normal to you. And that level of dysfunction will determine how many of these lies you fall for. I'm not making the rules. I'm just calling the game here. And if I don't do it, who's gonna do it? I'm sick and tired of you guys falling for this shit. Because if you fall for this shit, you might just fall into the 18th hole, and that's 6 feet deep. And there's nothing more tragic than an individual skipping half of the golf course and going directly to the 18th hole. There's a whole lot of that game you missed, and if you're successful at finding your own happiness, that game can actually be fun. Learn to laugh, especially at yourself, and take responsibility. The Popster is out. These dudes have to jump through hoops of fucking fire. turn their bodies into some type of Adonis. You know, become these just ruthless businessmen who make $500,000 or more dollars a year, have a six pack and be 6 feet tall, and deal with all of that other horseshit just for a woman who's 170 fucking pounds on average and has had 10 to 15 cocks run through her. It's not fucking worth it.